Now moving on to the next presentation, I would like to call Dr. Nadia Ali. She is working as a consultant dermatologist in Faisalabad Medical University, and she is going to give a talk on the treatment of keloids with low dose intralesional 5-fluorouracil with steroids. So welcome.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. I am going to present my topic, comparison of the efficacy of intralesional low dose 5-fluorouracil plus steroids versus steroids alone in keloid. This is my city, Faisalabad, from where I belong. This is my parent institute, Punjab Medical College, which is Faisalabad Medical University nowadays. This is my current department where I am working now. As you all know, keloid, it's a benign, well-demarcated area of fibrous tissue or growth that extends beyond its original defect. This is keloid, picture showing keloid on front of chest. Another picture having keloid. Complications, patients usually face these complications, pruritus, pain, restriction of movement, cosmetic disfigurements, irritability, tenderness, cryotherapy, radiation, pressure therapy. Different treatment modalities are available nowadays: cryotherapy, radiation therapy, pressure therapy, intralesional steroids, interferons, 5-fluorouracil, topical silicone, pulse dye laser, excision, skin flap, and grafting. Objective of my study was to compare the efficacy of low-dose 5-fluorouracil plus steroids versus steroids alone in keloid. What is 5-fluorouracil? It's a pyrimidine analog with anti-metabolite activity, which has been shown to inhibit fibroblast proliferation in tissue culture. And this is the mechanism of action. It is converted to 5-fluoro-2-deoxyuridine monophosphate, which causes inhibition of the enzyme thymidylate synthetase, and which ultimately causes inhibition of the DNA synthesis. And how does triamcinolone works in keloid? It causes inhibition of protein synthesis, inhibition of fibroblast migration, and enhances degradation of collagen. Study design, it was a randomized controlled trial and was conducted at Department of Dermatology, DHQ Hospital, Faisalabad. Sample size was 75 patients in each group, and it was non-probability consecutive sampling method. This is the inclusion criteria. It included 20 to 50 years of age patients. Both male and females were included, and patients with symptomatic keloids were included in the study. Exclusion criteria was treatment within the past 6 months, chronic renal failure, patients with any abnormalities in their liver function tests or complete blood count, pregnancy or planning pregnancy in near future, and lactation. Protocol was after approval of the ethical committee, informed consent was taken from the patients. Investigations were being carried out for complete blood count, liver and renal function test, because the drug is metabolized in the liver and excreted through the kidneys. Photographs were taken at baseline and then periodically. These are the injections which I used: 5-fluorouracil, normal saline for dilution, xylocaine for sublesion anesthesia, and triamcinolone acetonide.